Are you looking at maybe recording your screen for some gameplay, or maybe you want to create a tutorial of some app you have on your computer? Well, the Windows 11 has a built-in screen recorder that you can use for free. And today on Teachers Tech, I want to show you how you would use this and maybe why you wouldn't want to use this and use a different one. Let's get started. So first of all, where are you going to find this screen recorder on Windows 11? If you just go to the search down here, you can search for, I have it right here, but just the Xbox game bar. So if you type that in, you can see this is what we're looking for. You do not need to have an Xbox to use this. So I'm going to go ahead and click on this, and then I'm just going to toggle some of these things. So you can see captures right here, and it wasn't on because all these, if the blue line isn't under these, then it won't show. So here's just to point out some other things. When you first turn it on, you might have everything turned on like this that shows things from audio to resources to performance on it. So right now for this tutorial, all I want to have on at the moment is just the capture here. So the capture works quite easily. Just pointing out a few different things here. So we have our take a screenshot. So the screenshot just takes a picture of the screen. You can see the shortcuts as I hover over them. The other thing I want to point out, and this might be kind of why you might not want to use this, depending on what you, how you're going to use it. Notice right now, I cannot record. That's because I don't have an app open. You need to have an app open in order to have this record. So I'm going to open something in a moment, and then you're going to be able to see it. Also, I just want to point out, you can turn mic on while recording just by toggling this on and off like so. Now, the other way you can get to this and using the shortcut, if you don't want to go to the Xbox game bar, just simply hold the window sign down and the G at the same time. The G stands for game. So if I wanted to record an app, I'm just going to go ahead and open up an app now. I have this app open here. Now I'm just going to use the shortcut for the Windows and the G, and you can see when this comes up, I have the record, and all I have to do is simply click this right now and it's capturing. I'm going to just move this down so it shows how much it's captured, the status. I can stop it right here. And you can see, turn the microphone on also. In this case, for the tutorial, I don't have it on, but I can turn it on, and then it's going to start recording the voice in this. So it's going to go simply until I hit stop, and you can see game clip was recorded. Even though I have the whole screen, it doesn't take up the whole screen. The only thing that's being recorded is the window. So now, show all captures. If I go to show all captures, if I look at this right here, I have this being recorded. You can see how it's recorded the gameplay in there. These are all my previous ones. You might want to open up the file where everything's being stored. You could delete this if you want to. You can see how I could edit the names of this. So you'd get a series of different recordings on this. So even if I opened up another app, if I closed down this one right here, and let's say if I was doing a tutorial on, we'll just open up Microsoft Word. As soon as I have Microsoft Word open on this computer, and I'm hitting the shortcut again on it, like so, I have this here. So I can go ahead and click this, and let's say I'm doing a tutorial here on Microsoft Word as I go through, and I'll just click on a few things, and I'll just draw, and I'm going to go ahead and stop it. And game clip recorded. So now I'm just going to go to, I'll click on that blue, and I can see right here, I'm going to go ahead and hit play. And you can see the recording. And at this point, there's going to be a little bit of audio. You might not be able to hear it when playing back, but you can see what's happening right there. So that's just a little bit about the recording. Something I want to point out now, if you're doing a series of different clips, you might want to have them edited also. So if I just go ahead and open up, I'm just going to open up the local file. So these are being stored in the file. So that's the clip right here. If I go ahead, double click on it, you can see this is the recording that was just captured. I could hear it a little bit. I'll just open this back up again. But what you can do with these, you could upload these straight to wherever to share them. You could upload them to YouTube. But maybe you want to do some editing. And I just want to point out here, there is a video editing app on Windows 11 too, and I have a different tutorial on that. If you go ahead and search for video editor and open up this app, you can actually trim or add music to these clips or put them all together in one longer one. But take a look at that tutorial that I have that will help you do that. So what I want to do now though is look at some of the settings inside this capture screen for Windows 11. Where you're going to find some of the settings are right up here in this, right? So I'm going to go ahead and click on this, and I just want to point out a few things. I'm not going to go through everything. You might want to change your shortcuts here. So you can create your own shortcuts. You can see right now it's the Windows plus G, but if you wanted something else, you could change that. So any of these, you could go through and change them. As I go through, I just want to look at the capturing here. You can see record in the background while I'm playing a game if you want to enable that. Go take a look at the game features if you are using this for recording games. The other settings I want to show you are in the Windows setting for Windows 11. To find these other settings, just go to your search here and we're going to just type in capture settings. I have it coming up here. I just want to point out a few things you might want to customize to get it how you want. You can save to a different folder through here too. You can open the folder, record what's happening. So you can see the shortcut through here by pressing Window logo key plus Alt plus G to capture the moment on or off. What's the maximum length? Are you going to be doing some longer than 2 hours here? You can see where you can move it to 4 hours or go less. Capture audio and recording games. We can change our frame rate. Do we want it on 30 or 60 here? Video quality, you can improve that by going to high. Remember, that would be a larger file. And then capture mouse cursor when recording a game. You could turn that off if you don't want your mouse to be there. So I hope you like this little tutorial of how to use the Windows screen recorder. It's very, very easy to use, but as I said, it has to have that window open or that app open in order for it to work. So if you want to capture the whole screen, this wouldn't be a great one for you. But I hope you like this little tutorial today on it. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time with more tech tips and tutorials.